I don't know if somebody even cares about what I'm going to say, but I'm kind of speechless. I just watched a skeleton video breakdown by Patrick from Disenthralled about Mark Pescio's video about natural law. And whoa, it's crazy to me. I've watched Mark Pescio's radio shows, this year. It's quite a lot of content to go through. And his, presentations. And it is for me so interesting to see this, because it is definitely a learning experience, because you see the logic going there that goes against it, and it helps you to rethink it over, like, no, it does make sense. And I don't say I will be, because I'm not really in debate or something like that, I don't care about that, it's not my style. I do get beforehand, like what Mark Pescio is saying, is like the message is not getting there, people don't get it, and it's a lot smaller than you think, that a lot of people don't get it, and that's why also we are in this mess that we are in right now as a collective. But then I was thinking, like, somebody like him, a fellow anarchist, I would consider that he gets it, but he doesn't get it. So the group is even smaller. And, whoa, that's kind of terrible. He's talking like, where's the evidence? I think you see the video, you see the footage of the cops hitting people. Don't you see that it's not going well, you know? Don't you see it's in a downward spiral? And then he's like, yeah, let's say he didn't mention the Roman Empire, but that was also a bad system. So their laws were not moral. So you cannot say like, oh yeah, but then the laws were different and those were okay. No, they're all man-made laws, so they were not moral. So you cannot even, that's not an argument to begin with. He mentioned a different civilization, but it doesn't matter for the point I try to make. Maybe he does. But that's exactly what Mark Pescio says in the radio show. And to be honest, be fair, because it's not my type of content that he makes, because he likes to argument about a lot of, let's say, philosophy. It's not my type of thing that I care about. But I've watched some things with when he interviews like Macy, that is more a spiritual person. And you can see it's like a right brain talking, Macy, the spiritual one, and the left brain, and that's Patrick. And there's a disconnect. He doesn't get it. And that's precisely what Mark Pescio in his radio show tells about. But he is totally unaware of it, or something like that. He cannot see it, and it's like there's a wall. And it's like, where's the evidence? Where's the evidence? And so maybe the point to try to make is, that's the same like people that don't see that government is not immoral. That's the same that people don't get that government is immoral. They cannot see it. Well, for me, it's like, look around. The evidence is everywhere. Lockdowns and all the bullshit they tell you. It's just a person. It's just people telling other people what to do. That's all it is. And then you got some immoral pieces of shit that obey those laws, in the sense they enforce it to those people to keep them in line. And that's how the system works. But people don't see it now. Oh no, they don't. Yeah, they are hitting me right now, but it's for my protection. Or they give me fines, but it's to protect me, otherwise it would be chaos. Alright, right. But they cannot see it, and you can see it with something like that. And sure, there was a short video, more introduction video. But you can see that defensive wall and the judgment, it was kind of amazing to see. And it's like, for me, like, helpful. It was a helpful video to watch, because you get people like that. They are really like, because like, in a sense, Patrick really reminds me of my brother. He's really also like that. Every time I say things like that, he's really skeptical. It's like, no, the things are not going that way, and where's the evidence? And it need to be said, and I don't say that Patrick is like that, I don't know Patrick that well, but like with my brother, it's like, it need to be said by that and that of person with status, otherwise it doesn't count, you know, and that's just silly, you know. But yeah, I don't know if this is helpful for people, but it's like, it's terrible. I was thinking, you see, and of course I get it. If one video would do it, then we would not be in this shit, you know. That's not how it works. But, I definitely get his frustration of Mark Pesciano, because I thought I did before, but even people are so far, and I don't say that Mark Pesciano is all the way there or something like that, like he is the one, but man, there are people, they make, and they make a lot of, like there's somebody like Patrick does a lot of work, so I don't say that he is not no any good or something like that. He does way more than I do. Who am I, you know? But man, I'm just starting out. It's crazy to see, like, we still have so long to go. I don't think we have the time. I really don't think we have the time anymore. And, man. Yeah, I think I'll leave it by that. I think I need it to just get off my chest, I guess. It's so hard to change somebody's mind. Same for me. Took a lot to break it. I mean, there are a lot of points in my life, like, there are, like, I felt like this world, you could say, system. It's probably in a bad way, but I did not view it like that, but I really call it the world. It's not alright, it's broken, and it's horrible. That's kind of why I look myself away mentally, just try to flee. But I did not get how fucked up it really was, really, totally not. And I really have to hit rock bottom before I was even kind of remotely open to accept it. And the crazy thing for me, I mean, I've been at that place where Patrick was as well, like, the spiritual things, just like woo-woo, and I do get that, because I've been there as well. And the funny thing with me was that I just, as an exercise for writing a comic book story, I was working on that. I just said, like, don't judge it, just listen to it and apply it in that storyline. In that world, it's reality. Just drop down that shield, that wall, like, it cannot be real. And maybe that's a good exercise for somebody who is like that. Just say, like, for 1 week, stop going in the attack mode, because it's so crazy. With that's something I found so crazy when watching Patrick. He's but that's probably the point of the show he made. Is in attack mode. Then how can you be open? But again, that's probably the point of that episode, and it's good also for me at least to view it, like, because people are attacking when you tell them, like, chemtrails, things like that, is like, that's ridiculous, and they go in attack. So it's good to, as a mental exercise, to view that and, like, still go in your mind, like, no, because this, it's alright, you know, it does, I'm speaking the truth, you know, at least I got some good evidence, and then he needs to really point out why, and probably a lot of people just, they say things, assume things, and really don't want to view it as a bad thing. And it's like a religion, you know. But the point I was trying to make, that's maybe a good thing. Just as an exercise, just if you have some topics, because like somebody like Patrick is, I viewed that with Macy, and then she kind of challenge him to be open-minded, to go do this, and I think, if I can remember correctly, he did kind of accept that, and I think that's really a good exercise, because so long it's not really hurting your body or something like that, it's good to try new things and to be open-minded. Otherwise, for me, especially for my journey, let's say, otherwise you would never expand your horizon, you know. You would never get it. Then I would still, if I never tried alternative medicines, I would not be here right now. I really believe that I would not be here, because I was so drowned in self-hate, and my body was just giving up. So it was a lot of mental things that I did not get at the time that was so impacting my body, but it was also the way I eat, and it was all together, and I just needed that alternative medicine thing to kind of detox and give that boost again, like, oh, I can continue, I can go on. And then the entire thing kind of felt like a jigsaw puzzle together, like, then it was like, I'm more spiritual, like a soul, and things like that. I think it's at least the mental thing and the physical, this body, they are connected in a sense. If you're really mentally really toxic to yourself, your body get toxic. Let's say even if you are exercising well and eating well, if you are really talking yourself down and have really negative beliefs about yourself, you're still in a way poisoning yourself. Let's say somebody from me on the past would are like, that sounds crazy, you know, but I think it's really important that because it really, really is. And yeah, you can say, yeah, that's what you say, where's the evidence? Be freaking open-minded, because it's, the evidence is in when you look at those people and how they live. If you cannot see that, then there's no really hope for you, I guess. And it doesn't mean that they are perfect. They are still working on themselves and they got issues. Nobody here is perfect. But there are things like... And they can probably learn things from you as well. But if you're really that close-minded and it's like everything that's gonna be said is like, where's the evidence? I don't see it. Where... If you were more open-minded, you can see it, but it's so, you go to a filter, like it has to be presented in this and this way or something, you cannot see it anymore. I think that is something I needed to say today, I guess. Because you got, let's say, the people on the street, let's say the regular people, the sheeple, the asleep. They never think about those things. So they don't have an argument. They don't really have a really standpoint. It's just a belief, a wish, like, oh no, government can never be this way because that would be horrible. So because I find that horrible, they will not do that. I make the rules, the law. Things cannot be terrible because I don't want to. Oh, really? Good. Like, people in World War II probably wanted that then. Okay, it's working like that. You know, they don't, and I don't blame them. You cannot think about everything in life, of course. The same if I would bark on the street and somebody would give me philosophy questions, of course. I probably a lot of things are also like, I need to really think about this. I think I would have that really a lot. And maybe at the end of the interview would be like, ooh, I really need to think about that. Maybe probably give really garbage answers right now. But maybe when I think about it, it's like, oh, yeah. Because I'm normally not thinking about things like that. And you have to consider... Most of the people are not doing that. And is that a good thing? And does that say about the conditioning people have? I think a lot. It does say a lot about that. But that's more like a belief that you want to protect. It's like a child that believes in Santa Claus and that will protect them because he wants that to be true. You know, the presents and a nice fairy tale and things like that. And the realization is that a lot of people don't have. They still do that behavior. They still have that behavior for a few things. Let's say the Xbox fanboy against the PlayStation fanboy, they are really believing that that thing is the best, and they are not open-minded to see like, oh, it's pretty much the same thing but a different logo, and they have got some different games, of course there are differences, but you get the point. You get those really religious type like, this is the best one and this is garbage, and they are not open-minded to look like, oh, what got they in common in sense. And it doesn't even make sense at some points when you hear those type of people talk, you know, it's crazy. And you got that with a lot of things, and they don't see that connection because they are not, let's say, used to think, you know. This is basically the best way to say it. They're not used to think. They just do and react. That's all they do. Yeah. I think I'll leave it with this. And I hope it was kind of useful. For me at least, it kind of helped me to kind of get it off my chest. One more thing, what I was kind of thinking when I was closing the camera. That sense that you need to have evidence, and that is really your ego. That's your kind of your sense, like, this is what I am. I'm the one that gonna prove things. And it needs to be in this shape and form. And that's why that can be blinding for you. Because you expected to see it in this shape, and it makes you rigid. You cannot see it. It cannot flow to you, let's say. Sometimes, as with being creative, sometimes you're stuck and then you have to just take a walk back, take a little break from it and look with it with fresh eyes. And I think that is what kind of gets you stuck when you are in that evidence mode. And especially when you are the type that is really like, things need to be 100% correct. And it's so left brain, it's like, it's without being too stereotypical, but it's like a German, the stereotypical German, that things need to be really precise, so focused on it, versus somebody that's creative and just create things and goes more with the flow. It's two different opposites, and you can, what do I want to say with that? Maybe that are two different energies. Totally two different energies. Really the right and left brain. And it's good to have that in balance because you need both. I think that's what I want to say with it. You really need both, because otherwise, if you are too loose and things with that, some things that require technical precision don't get done. Then it's like throwing mud at something until it suddenly works, you know. It's too random and you don't even know what you have done. But on the other hand, if you're always so focused on every millimeter that you are shaving off and adding, and you do that with everything, it takes ages to get there. Because you're so, it needs to always be perfect. Sometimes you need to take it in the broad picture. And that is more, that's the big difference. Sometimes you need to see it in the broad picture. Just take it in. Just take the parts you can use at this point and move on. Again, that was not the point of his show, of Patrick. So I do get that it wasn't point of his show to not be like, we're gonna take it in the world. But he likes to do, I believe he likes to do those type of shows that he's kind of. And I did see some value in it. It's not like that I say it's a wasted time or something like that, but I think it can help. If in the case you feel like it's bothering you that you are doing that, that's kind of what this video is for, I guess. That you kind of get stuck there, because it's way more useful when you can use both brain halves. You can balance them. And I don't say I'm always in this to have it in balance. Sometimes I do things that are really technical and other times more creative. And sometimes I do notice that it's kind of hard to switch one side off. Let's say I'm really technical, and then suddenly I get people come over and see me. Sometimes I'm still stuck in the technical stuff and I'm really stiff and you know, I'm not really social. That may be also because I'm not live not so social life, but that's something to say, but it does just make a difference in what side I'm in. But but when you are stuck in one of those sides, because you can also be stuck in the right side way too much, and that's something that Mark Pescio covers in his radio show. So if you're willing to invest the time in that, I highly recommend watching Mark Pescio's radio show and really start from show number one. Otherwise you will be met with a lot of anger at the end of his show, because he's really frustrated. And I have to say, when you watch his entire radio show, I don't know the guy, of course, but you do get the sense like He invested so much energy. I explained it so much. And still so hard to reach people. And that's probably also why he's always saying from the beginning, pretty much, like, everybody needs to speak out. Because maybe the way I say this, some people will really resonate with this. And other people will way better resonate with things that Patrick is saying. Other people like what Mark Pescio is saying, the way he does. And there are many others, like Larkin Rose, also a really good speaker, anarchist. And because it can be, it's just hearing it at the right moment, in the right way, that can have so much impact in somebody. It will never be also one person that does it all to, let's say, awaken you, or let's say help you in your development. It sounds so condescending, but just let's say to see what's going on. And that's also, it's not like I know everything or something like that. I don't want to make it sound like I'm the high status guy, you know. And that is not what I try to say with it. It's there's a lot of hidden things going on, and it's really hard to really, really know what's going on. And that's why also when people are going like, this is the truth, it's with his research he may feel like this is the truth, but you cannot accept that one truth because you have not done the research. And then you can, it's not, it's so, the same amount of, let's say, foolishness is not the right way to say it in English, but to accept that, than to just blindly follow, let's say, government, or let's say a doctor, because he got some white coat on. No, don't use this alternative medicine. No, just use this chemotherapy. Yay! Let's kill you. That's basically what you do. But that's again where that open-mindedness comes in. You cannot expect yourself to fall with your nose on the ground in a book, on the bright page that gives you all the facts right now. There must be a moment in time where you are open-minded. But there need be, sure, there need be a healthy amount of skepticism as well. And that's where the left brain comes in. That's where the balance comes in. The right one is more, and I believe I say this correct, it's more like open, less skeptical, more the receiving side. Another one is more that judgmental side. More the thinking side. But that's where that balance is really important. So, but in case you're struggling with it again, try to exercise that just for 1 week or something like that, or just 2 days, let's say a weekend, to be open-minded, to just try, let's say if you're really against extraterrestrials things, and you're really like, I cannot see the evidence for that and things like that, and I totally get that. Just for 1 weekend, just watch those documentaries, and some maybe totally garbage. Let's say after those 2 days, you're like, finally I can totally demolish those foolish and stupid documentaries about it. I can finally, now I don't have to do the exercise, but just for those 2 days, try to do that. But at the same time, if you are really like the one that's always accepting everything that somebody says, try to be the skeptical person for those 2 days. there's a really, I think at least how I see it, a healthy way to kind of exercise both brains. To, let's say if you overuse the left one, to kind of give that right one some practice. But that's the same way around as well. If you're really always right brain, give that left brain some practice. You may need to do that a few times. You may totally hate that, but it's really important to keep that in balance. And I think in the end it will make you a better person, more balanced. And I don't want to say at all that I am I'm there or something like that. I got a lot of issues, but being aware of that is a good start. And then you need to work on that. And I think I'll leave it with that. And see you guys next time. I think this was something that I needed to say, I guess. So, this is interesting, you can see, I had a bad feeling after watching the intro. I was really oh man, what's going on? Things are going to shit, and now I do this. And I feel that was really relieving. But also, there was a reason why I had a bad feeling. I needed to speak out my, what was bothering me, I guess. Also what I had to say. And it was a time that I need to say something. What I tried to say is instead of being, let's say, hateful and toxic in the comments, when you see something that you don't like, you can also just take a moment and really think about it. What is going on in your mind? And then maybe, for somebody at least, I hope, out there, it kind of gives something that is productive. Instead of just cursing and go you're a fool, you don't get it. You know, where's the evidence? Where's the evidence? I don't know. But just being stupid and silly in the comments. Just think about what's going on. And do you recognize yourself in that? On the past or things like that, or maybe something you still struggle with and you're so happy that you're kind of sometimes not struggling with it, and then now you're reminded about it you're struggling with that. I don't know what's going on in your mind, of course, but again, I will quit, otherwise I keep going on.